Hello, everybody, and welcome to the final WePlay game of the day. We have got Shazam versus Elite Wolves. I'm Llama Down Under, joined by Minnie. How you doing?
Yeah, I'm doing good. Thanks for having me,
Thanks for
Loma, and
joining.
I'm glad to be back from casting.
I am glad you're here.
Greetings, team.
My other Minnie is graciously stepping in. My co-host, who was kind of meant to be here, power died apparently, and Minnie's like, "I'm up to it," so I'm
I'm ready,
excited.
boys.
Yeah, I'm actually really excited for this one. Elite Wolves have to win to stay in LAN contention with Digital Chaos. Of course, that's assuming that Digital Chaos win all their matches as well. But right now, it is looking like, I mean, DC's been sweeping their group.
10
Elite Wolves
seconds
also need to
remaining.
win here, and if they lose, they're in a lot of trouble. Now,
5 seconds
got an Enchantress
remaining.
already out. The OD has been banned, something Elite Wolves loves to pick up, along with the Mirana and Earth
Reserve
Spirit,
time.
Beastmaster, Death Prophet. All pretty standard bans.
Yeah, I'm just wondering whether Shazam are going to run this Enchantress in the offlane. Like normally in the NA scene, it's always offlane Enchantress. But like we saw in the major, like already that
Greetings,
Enchantress can be
team.
played like, a lot of like secondary support, and that can really sort of assist in the offlane. But I think because obviously this is North American Dota, with Shazam, I'm probably going to see Enchantress as the offlane pretty standard normally.
Yeah, I think America hasn't quite shown the Enchantress as a support much. Elite Wolves is actually one of the teams that will sometimes run that, but they vastly prefer it on the offlane. Venge, always a solid pickup, and
10
it's
seconds
actually for Elite
remaining.
Wolves, this could be carry or support. They're very flexible,
Dire
and they go
team
for the
pick.
Mirana again. They love this pickup.
It's really rare though. Like I think Mirana in itself is a hero that's quite rare, but if we do ever see Mirana, it's with paired with the OD because of how easy it is to execute the the imprisonment plus the arrow. But with a Vengeful Spirit, it's not the easiest of setups, but I guess Elite Wolves feel comfortable when in playing it regardless.
Yeah, I think right now the OD plus the Mirana has something like an 80% win rate in professional games
Radiant
this patch.
team
It's
back.
a little ridiculous. Shazam get their hands on the Lone Druid. Chen also still in the pool. So I'm almost expecting Shazam to ban it out. It would be really greedy and imply that this Venge is carry, but it's something Elite Wolves do like running,
Dire
the support
team
Venge.
back.
Sorry, so there's Chen, even if they haven't lost.
Yeah. I mean, I do like the Mirana pickup here, even though they don't have the OD. It's something that it's a good way to deal with the Enchantress. I can't remember exactly what team did it, but one team was playing against Enchantress in the offlane, and then I think it might have been a secret game actually, and that team sort of picked up Mirana, and it was so good against Enchantress because you just keep on landing arrows and arrows onto Enchantress, and with that burst damage and with that stun, you can easily control Enchantress in the offlane, which normally is a hero that dominates by itself. So if you can really control the Enchantress, then that's a good way to start with a good start in the game.
Also, a good way to lock her down, give you enough time to actually bring her down, since she's such a pain to kill with that untouchable. Also, Ari can do a decent amount of damage for Shazam. Now their turn up to ban. They apparently do not think this is support Venge. They think it's carry Venge because they're banning out the Bane, or just wanting to not have that Bane Mirana set up another strong combo.
Yeah, I think they're just more scared of the Bane Mirana combo. I mean, Vengeful Spirit can definitely play support, but it kind of went through like a weird stage where we saw like Venge carry for a good like 2 or 3 weeks like permanently after like VP were playing it quite a bit, but then presumably it just sort of dropped off completely. I don't think we're going to see Venge carry probably in this game, and maybe not, but the hero itself is just obviously incredibly strong, incredibly versatile, and probably one of the strongest or most
back.
top first picks here. But we see Nature Prophet banned out as well, but there's still like, a lot of heroes that are like not open touch, like Invoker, Faces Void, but I guess you know NA have their own kind of meta themselves, and they pick a Brewmaster here for Elite Wolves.
Yeah, now this could be smashed offlane Brewmaster. That's something he really likes. I'm not sure, because I think Van probably also knows how to play the hero mid, or they can just rotate, because all the cores on everybody pretty much on Elite Wolves has played every role before. I'll be really interested to see exactly where it goes. Now for Shazam, though, Brewmaster can really wreck your face in a team
10
fight.
Seconds remaining.
So they might want to get some more control and ways to stop the Brewmaster from splitting.
5 seconds.
Yeah, Brewmaster's a good pick here, though. Like, it works well against both the Lone Droid and the Enchantress, though, because both the Enchantress plus the Lone Droid Bear are really good Cyclone targets, because they're easy to sort of chuck them up in the air, and then you can completely forget about them and go from there. So I do like the Brewmaster pick up here. It might be, maybe perhaps a little bit too early to pick up the Brewmaster, though, because there's obviously ways to counter it. Maybe a Sky Wrath Mage might be on the board, or perhaps, you know, Elite Wolves just have even more crazy picks in mind, so they have to pick the Brewmaster third, but Witch Doctor picks up here by Shazam.
Radiant team pick.
Now, it's going to be... Actually, really interesting, the Witch Doctor pickup. Faceless Void still hasn't been grabbed by either team, but I do expect Lone Druid offlane and the Brewmaster offlane, and it's going to be Van Tinker, which means this game is going to be a bit of potentially very low kills. The Van Tinker is something that they do bust out on Elite Wolves from time to time, but it's, what's the right way to say this? It doesn't actually always work.
Yeah, I don't think Tinker's kind of a viable hero in this meta, to be honest. Like, I think this meta is slowly becoming more sort of team fight and sort of pushing, whereas Tinker's more sort of split pushing, trying to find solo pickups by themselves. Now, I'm not saying that the hero can't work, but it just seems a little bit out of place, particularly in this meta. But one thing I want to go over, though, like, obviously it does have a little bit of synergy with the Brewmaster, though, because when you get the travels, then obviously you can travels on to the Brewlings, or whatever you want to call them, the minions of Brewmaster when he ulties, so you can set up a lot of kills through there in that way.
Yeah, there's, I mean, now with the Batrider picked up, both sides have some really good pickoff potential.
Remaining.
For Shazam, they also potentially can do the early pushing lineup, obviously. It's a bit weird with the Batrider, but you can go for a pickoff before you try to engage on the tower. You know, you get that blink up early, you lasso someone and quickly take them down. So Shazam may end up picking up something like a Jug, try and end the game earlier.
Yeah, like, already I prefer the Shazam's lineup and draft. Like, it just seems a lot easier to execute and just it seems easier to play. But simply, like, Elite Wolves seems to have to find a Tinker and the Marana both have to find a lot of kills for them to be kind of useful in this game. Because when it comes to team fights, like, they're just going to get, you know, locked down with, like, you know, the Witch Doctor, ulti, Batrider, Lasso, and there's still obviously the carry left for Shazam as well. So I think for Elite Wolves to sort of take this game, they've got to make a lot of work happen from this Marana and Tinker, especially.
Yeah. Now, Elite Wolves, their turn to ban out. I wouldn't be surprised if we see the Jug banned out. Other things they might be worried about maybe is a Spectre who could cause a lot of problems for the Tinker, even without the Zeus. She can still be a real pain. Do they have enough coverage, though, for a Spectre to be able to deal with a Venge, Marana, Brew, and Tinker coming at her?
I think one question you always have to ask if you're thinking about picking up a Spectre is that can you get like aggressively dual or like can you get a decent laning phase? Because if you can get a decent laning phase, I think Spectre's always a decent pick. I think one of the weaknesses of Spectre is obviously his laning phase, and if he's going to get pushed, well, I mean, Elite Wolves are not going to really look to do early push, so Spectre's fine on that chance. But in terms of the laning phase, I don't think there's anything that's going to be too scary to play against. So I think if the Spectre was to be pick up here, it would be a decent pick up here from Shazam if they do want to go with it.
Yeah, and it really just depends on exactly what the game plan they want. TC actually has a pretty wide hero pool, so I wouldn't be surprised to see them grab him something like that. Inspector, pretty in vogue right now. They actually end up... So Elite Wolves bans out the Chen, and I feel like they're the only team that would ban out the Chen here. They have been running Chen plus Enchantress, which just cracks me up. So.
Yeah. It's very great. I guess they assume this Lone Druid's going to play in the first position, though, the carry, which isn't out of the question. Like, and then I guess that would mean they're looking for another mid, then, if that was going to be the case. But I think it's going to be, most likely it's going to be Enchantress secondary support, which I was wondering in the first place. It's going to be offlane Batrider and then maybe carry Lone Druid. But there's a Spectre actually for Elite Wolves, so maybe taking it away from Shazam, perhaps.
Also could be something... I'm trying to think of some other fun setups. Maybe you get a long-ranged arrow on someone, Spectre can haunt and get the kill, or same with Tinker's rockets. Yeah, I guess one way to not have to ban it is to pick up the Spectre yourself. So
one issue, though, is that Shazam do have a lot of good push. So this Spectre, as well as the Tinker, like, they're going to need, like, you know, a good sort of 10 to 15 minutes of farm before they can be kind of effective in this game. And if this Lone Droid is going to be played in the short lane, then their towers are going to be under siege in the first sort of 5 minutes. And particularly if you have, you know, Enchantress roaming in as well with some creeps, and they've still got a last pick here as well. So if Shazam want to sort of bolster up their pushing, they easily can. And I think Elite Wolves will kind of struggle. Yes, obviously, when Tinker has, you know, his blink and his travels, then he's going to be easily able to defend against the push, but if the push is coming at like pre 10 minutes, then there's nothing Tinker can do at the time. So I'm wondering what Shazam are going to go with this. Like, even if they pick up something like a Jug, for example, would be kind of a bit of both in terms of team fight and push.
I think it's also really interesting here.
Oh, Crude, oh my god.
We'll touch on that in a second, but also Elite Wolves had the Venge. Shazam picked a Batrider into a Venge. That's always an interesting choice because Venge is seen as, you know, the one true counter to that. But then Broodmother, how about you go over that? Because this is going to be our second Broodmother game of the day. I'm not the biggest of fans of the Broodmother, but it's always a solid pick, and here it's not I mean, in the laning phase, it doesn't look like they have a good amount to deal with her.
They have nothing to deal with Broodmother, to put simply. Like, Venge Marama, I couldn't think of worse supports to deal with a Broodmother. Both very single target-based, and Spectre, again, is a hero that relies a lot on his supports to get anything in the lane. Like, I mentioned the two questions you have to ask yourself if you're playing, if you're wondering whether to pick a Spectre is, can I get away with it in the lane, and can I get away with it not getting pushed? And Shazam have both of these things. They're playing against a Broodmother, so it's going to wreck Elite Wolves lane phase, and also they got Lone Druid, Enchantress, and Brood, all who heavily focus on push. So, I mean, I have to give this draft advantage heavily to Shazam right now.
Yeah, I really like the Broodmother pickup. As you said, there's not a lot that they can do to deal with it, and I really like a lot of teams have been picking up the sneaky Broodmother. It just seems to be something that isn't worth a ban in the current meta, or people don't think it's worth a ban in the current meta, and then she's going to cause a lot of grief. So, I think it's just natural ebbs and flows of, hey, we haven't banned her in a while, and now we're gonna get punished by her and remember to ban her next time.
Yeah, like, I mean, they have ways to deal with Brood if they can get past the laning phase. Like, they have Spectre and Tinker, both who are great ways of sort of picking off the Broodmother. I'm just worried that can Elite Wolves kind of get anything in this laning phase before they just get run over, is my biggest question in this game.
Yeah, now we're going to be seeing early rotations out from both teams, all grouped up as five, going into the enemy jungle. They actually used a smoke on Elite Wolves. Shazam did not. He will find nothing, although Masoku does have arrows skilled up. Maybe he can find a big one here on bottom, but they may not realize they're running into all of them. They have to know. They have to know, based on finding nobody in the jungle and nobody at the top lane. The arrow is going to be completely wide. Four members of Elite Wolves are completely revealed here. Fun just throwing out the auto attacks, but they are all there. And the potential for wraparound with Enchantress with no creeps at this point in the game, I think, is slim. So, Elite Wolves getting themselves bottom rune.
Smart money.
Okay. They're going to continue to chase a little bit, but I imagine TC will eventually take this top one. He might be trying to save it. Oh, goodness. They have actually caught up to Brax. Hit him with an arrow. He is also stunned up by the Venge, and he'll be our first blood.
That's really unfortunate as well, though, because Batrider was saving up for early bottles, so giving away first blood is just going to really hamper him. He's going to buy a TP and come back to base, but still very, very frustrating.
I was not expecting that to go down that way. I did not think that they'd manage to land the arrow, but they do, and they get the catch-up, so... Now, in this mid-matchup, Batrider versus Tinker, obviously Batrider's got Sticky Napalm, but Tinker's got Laser, so who comes out on top?
Well, I would definitely give the advantage to Tinker. The only problem, though, is that I've got to deal with this Enchantress as well. With Enchantress's help, I definitely think I can give this over
to
Enchantress.
They're catching out MSS. He thinks there's a sentry, but in fact,
man,
he just got dusted, and they did actually... I don't know if they caught him in this sentry at first as to why they started dusting. They must have.
This is actually really kind of sad to see, though, because, like, I see this a lot from kind of... semi-decent roots is that, like...
Okay, in mid, though, Van's dying. And there is a TP rotation in, trying to do something to Savage. M, God, gonna see what he can do, but there is nothing. Okay, now quickly talk before more kills happen.
Yeah, so much action, I can't even talk. But it's like, just quickly going over that kill in mid, and this is what I mean, Batrider plus Enchantress is gonna really wreck this Tinker. If it was a pure one-on-one, I think Tinker would win it, but with Enchantress' help, it's gonna be in favour of Batrider. And going back to the Broodmother as well, is that this Broodmother has to realise, if there's three people in this lane, all he needs to do is soak up experience, because if he can pull the Mirana and Venge over to the bot lane, then Batrider can completely win his matchup mid. The problem is, when Broodmother starts dying, then he's gonna give it away experience over to Venge and give experience over to Mirana. If he can just sort of play defensive for the first 6 minutes, then he'll get the level advantage and then can start dominating the lane. But with his early death already, it does put him a little bit behind in trying to secure this lane for himself.
Yeah, he's, as you said, he needs to make some more pressure. They've done a really good job hiding this sentry. Obviously, that helped them set up that first blood. And MSS gonna have trouble finding that. Oh, why is it? It spoke too soon. MSS does manage to get the jump on it. And Enchantress even coming in to maybe apply some pressure to this bottom lane.
But yeah, I think as long as Broodmother is just not dying in this lane, I think they're going to be fine. Like, if you have to sort of commit three heroes to shut down a Broodmother, then I think that's the whole point of the Broodmother. Like, you're getting a lot of use out of it. That way the Enchantress can, you know, pressure on mid, and then Witchdog can pressure on top as well. But when Broodmother starts giving away kills, that's when, you know, the Broodmother pick is not worthwhile.
Well, we already have one creep destroyed by the arrow. Masoku thinking about maybe getting some more on there. And yeah, this Enchantress plus the Broodmother already causing a lot of pain in this bottom lane. So, Spectre getting pressured some. Now, on top, we haven't talked about it much. This Beastmaster already level 3.
It's not too bad, to be honest. I think he's going to be a little bit in trouble when Lone Droid hits level 5. Because when he's level 5, then Bear's going to have a chance to root. And I think with root plus Witch Doctor's Maledict plus Paralyzing Cross, they have a potential to kill. But without root, I don't think they have a potential to kill yet. So look for the level 5 on Lone Droid for a potential on the kill.
Oh, and in bottom, the baby spiders looking like they're going to be taken out, Mystico. And now Masoku in a lot of trouble as well. There are a lot of spawned spiderlings here, done up by MSS.
And Enchantress is using a Whirlwind Ripper as well to really annoy the Tinker, which just gives even more help to this Batrider. And as a result, like, he's doing decently. And I think the biggest thing is that although Tinker might be doing decently on farm, like, he just has a supreme more kill potential now on the Tinker, and actually top lane. Yeah. Level 5 on Lone Droid expected, and there was the kill I was talking about before.
Now, this farming Lone Droid, we don't often see the safe lane at Lone Droid. Obviously, it feels like the item progression is the same. Maybe get yourself an early Midas, try to work on a Radiance. Do you think there are any changes that need to be made for this game, this lineup?
Nah, I think this is the same way. Like, I think you play the Lone Droid the same way, whether you play him offlane or in the short lane. I think you just go Midas into Radiance.
And I missed a kill on the Brood down bottom. She does manage to end up getting the Marana. It looks like she'll also catch the Venge. So Broodmother, she may have missed out on that experience, but she suddenly got a number of kills. Is she going to catch out Iwo as well? No time to look at that, because we've got Enchantress facing up against Van in their jungle. The Batrider is trying to come in time.
Where are you going?
It's looking like Van will be slowed. Batrider still trying to gap close. They will have another clap, which will slow, but they kill the creep, so there's no gap. No clap. And now Tinker, he walks down on Watch the Machines. One more auto attack would do it. The Sticky Napalm's coming out and he's salved up. Brax taking quite a bit of damage. Will Masoku be able to hit the next arrow? 4 seconds. Brax just wandering away. It looks like they'll be fine.
Interesting skill build though by this Batrider as well, maxing out Napalm. It's something you'd never see S4 do if he played mid Batrider. Like, it wouldn't have mattered on that kill there down to Tinker, but normally you go 2-on-2. Because a third point in Sticky Napalm just doesn't really help or increase that much compared to the extra point in Firefly. Like, if you look at the scaling, like, it goes up to 20 damage per second on Firefly when you put it to level 2, whereas the scaling on the Sticky Napalm is like 2% on movement slow and 5 extra damage, so not very worthwhile, but interesting nonetheless.
And as you mentioned, the fears are becoming real, right? Shazam, they're off to a good early start. The Broodmother, despite 2 deaths, is top of the net worth chart, and has more than enough to deal with Mirana and the Venge. And suddenly, this early push might be coming well before the Spectre and the Tinker are ready.
And this just all goes back to the draft, honestly. I mentioned it, like, Aliwolf's draft is so strange and so weird, and it's not working out for him so far, but middle lane.
Okay, they throw
trouble.
The stun out onto Brax, but now they're Sticky Napalmed up, standing in the Firefly a bit. Masoku gonna leap up to the high ground and get away. They tried for that gank while Van was off getting the rune.
Batrider hasn't even specced Lasso yet. I have to assume that's a misclick. Like, I only refer back to S4 because I think he's like the best Batrider in the world in terms of solo mid. And I think if he had Lasso there, he could have easily maybe turned onto the Marana. But alas, no, he has Lasso now, but yeah, turned level 7. But
yeah, sometimes, you know, as you said, you just sometimes click the wrong buttons. Either way, they are beginning to pull ahead on Shazam. 3k net worth lead, over 2,000 experience, and this is a very troubled Spectre, right? She had to leave bottom lane full health just because of how big this Broodmother is.
And this is after Broodmother, like, died at level 1. I think that the help from Enchantress playing in the enemy jungle has helped him a lot, actually. But, yeah, he's completely destroying. Like, he's top net worth against 3 other heroes, which is just absurd. Like, he's, like, winning this game by himself, practically.
Yeah, and this is just the Broodmother effect, right? She always does this. You let her get level 5, she kills everyone.
Yeah, particularly when, like, you have a draft, like, you have Venge, Mirana, Spectre, all heroes that are very, very weak against Broodmother. Like, I mean, 5th pick Broodmother, this is just the stuff that happens, presumably.
Now, Enchantress thinking about coming in onto Smash. He does have a Mango, although currently not enough for that, Thunderclap. He's gonna have to use it. He's gonna have to give somebody the clap at some point. He's gonna use it, trying to hit the Enchantress as well. He doesn't have enough for his ult, but doesn't matter. Spectre haunts in. They've got a lot of supports around here. Can they land the arrow they need? It's off the mark, but they have dusted up MSS. They need another slow to get anything done, and they're not able to catch the Broodmother while the baby spiders decimate Smash.
Yeah. One thing I'd like to see, actually, is I'd like to see Shazam put a bit more pressure on this top lane. I mean, this Lone Drone has been sort of farming up here by himself, and obviously with the Brewmaster rotation down bottom, but I think they need to be putting a lot more pressure on this top lane, because I mentioned when Tinga gets his boots travel, he's going to be able to stop a lot of the push, so you want to try and get as much pushing as you can before Tinga's is sort of an issue. And I think the T1 tower in the short lane here for Dire is the easiest tower to get, so they need to put a bit more pressure on it.
I'm a little bit surprised that the Lone Druid without a contested lane doesn't have his Midas up yet, but I mean, I think he has it.
He's got it now.
Yeah, he gets it now.
It's fine. He's top net worth. Like he bought like boots and stuff and all the venom, so he's fun.
Yeah, obviously prioritizing some of those other items over it. I mean, he's certainly doing much better than the Spectre. He's 1k ahead of the Spectre, and that is only going to grow. More Elite Wolves. What do you do here? You need to buy time. How do you find it?
I think you have to rely on Marana hitting arrows, or like try and roam, like, because there's nothing else you can really do. Like, Brewmaster doesn't have blink, so you can't really set up kills there. Tinker's sort of focused on farming, so is Spectre, so it has to be this Marana creating space, but unfortunately arrows are not always the easiest to hit, and when Batrider's just picked up his blink at 9 minutes, then it's not going to be Elite Wolves taking control of this game, it's going to be Shazam.
Yeah, these early towers certainly going to be helping out Shazam a bunch, and as we talked about, this is a really important match for Elite Wolves. They need to keep winning all of their replay matches so that they're tied with Digital Chaos, and they're in a bad spot right now. 5,000 net worth behind, they're usually the team that takes the lead. Now, up in top, they're looking like they want to do something onto Smash. He does have Primal Split ready. So we will see.
Maybe.
Okay, yep, it looks like they're gonna be able to get the kill onto Avenge. They do get the return kill onto the Broodmother, and that's a killing spree, but oh gosh, he is taking a lot of damage. He does manage to get on out, and the gank at top never came.
I'm so surprised, but why didn't Batrider TP in there? Like, if he TPs in bottom, he's got blink, like, he can easily secure the kill on the Spectre, then maybe even save the Broodmother, but instead decides not, and I think that's a missed opportunity, honestly.
Also, releasing some of the pressure on the rest of Elite Wolves' lineup allows Van to get himself those Boots of Travel up. So suddenly the Tinker, he's not scary yet, right? But he's something.
Yeah, he's not scary, but I think this Travels is a really big pickup right now, because, I mean, Shazam, they no longer can really effectively push, because with Travels on Tinker, like, he just spams that March of the Machines, as he's doing right now, and that's the end of the push. And I think they should have got more before Travels was picked up on the Tinker, because of how much of a dominating position Shazam were in. So I think Brood's going to definitely have a bit of a harder time now Travels are picked up by the Tinker.
Now, it looks like they're grouping up for a smoke. Shazam, I think they know about Brax's blink. Maybe that's why he didn't TP in. I don't know whether it's been revealed yet, but he certainly got the blink and then some more in change, and he should be able to secure them, this bottom tower. Spectre is actually deep under the tower. Iwo wants nothing to do with this.
I think Tinker can't.
Well, they know. Spectre uses the horn, tries to stop the blink, but Brax is there with the Oh my goodness! It runs out, and instead Spectre goes all the way top. Onto Lone Druid, and now we'll see if they can get any return kills. They are all invisible, unfortunately. Right under a sentry, Brax on the sidelines. Firefly should be running out soon. There it goes. They're now standing in the March of the Machine. Smash has taken quite a bit of damage. Is under the effects of Maledict. He may actually need to use his salve carefully here. Yeah, he's gonna.
But that's
when,
like, Shazam just rotated like four heroes down bottom and sort of tried to look for the push, but Tinker comes in once and just does like two or three March of the Machines, and they're kind of forced back, and I think Tinker's actually going to travel down here again and do the same thing, so it really puts Shazam's pushing on the back foot because of it.
They did manage to force out the haunt though, and nothing really was gained from it, so we'll see Batrider going for it again. They do have Glyph for this tower, they haven't used it yet. There are a lot of spiders. Van coming in, using that March. Finally he's going to throw the Glyph out, and as you said, with that, the push is gone.
Oh, Spectre.
Spectre gonna try to find something. Oh no, she's gonna try to find her own death. They managed to get a big stun onto Fun. Can they follow it? Smash, he's using that Primal Split. We'll see if they can kill off both Brax and this little tossed up in the air Witch Doctor. They've gotten Brax, and it's looking like Witch Doctor should be soon to follow. Fun taking a lot of damage, even with the spiders from MSS. They're not gonna find anything on the lineup of Shazam other than the Spectre.
That Brewmaster was like the saving grace there for Elite Wars. Like, that Spectre literally just came in such an awkward angle, like, got picked off instantly, but luckily the Brewmaster was there to turn the tide of battle, luckily. Oh man, Orkin on Broodmother. 12 minutes or 13 minutes in, man, this is scary for Elite Wolves now.
Yeah, we haven't discussed it, but I mean, this Broodmother, she didn't have the easiest of games, right? But she's almost at 500 GPM anyway. MSS has 3 deaths, is still almost at 500 GPM.
Yeah, he's smashed it, honestly. Like, I criticised him a little bit for getting picked off at the start, but he's bounced back so much, and he's just destroying everyone. And the thing is, like, now he's got Orchid, there's no one that can really contest him down bot. Like, anyone shows up in this lane, bottom lane, they're going to die. If it's a Spectre, if it's anyone, they're just going to die. And now this puts so much pressure on the side of Elite Wolves, because Spectre's now forced to rotate top to try and find his farm. But, I mean, if he tries to farm top, then there's a potential for Batrider to be there as well. Like, Shazam have so many opportunities and abilities to just solo kill heroes. And that just puts, you know, Elite Wolves in such a poor position, honestly.
Yeah, they're also just continuing to expand their lead. Obviously, Shazam, an easier time farming this map with the Broodmother and also the Midas just making gold for them out of thin air. This TC is going to have a very early Radiance, unless they manage to do something on Elite Wolves, and I'm not sure if they saw... Okay, they now know about the Moonlit Shadows using this ward, so the Mod Stoop... come out. Bears just got
no,
a wonder out of it. Huh?
No Brewmaster ulti, though. I think that's the biggest thing. Like, that was the reason why they got salvaged the last team fight. But without Brewmaster ulti this time, I don't think they can fight it. Not against an Orchid Broodmother with 13 minutes in.
Yeah, and unfortunately, oh, here comes the Broodmother Spiders. Brax also around, getting ready to blink in. He's gonna go for it on Van, gets the lasso. Immediately, the Haunt comes out. There is a march down, but Van, he's getting very low, and he will drop. They'll catch out SVG, but it's not enough. They need more from this engagement. Iwo bursting forwards, trying to find something. He's going in onto Brax. They manage to catch out the Broodmother, and they get Brax, and that is a huge win for the lineup of Elite Wolves. Oh, they had to buy back, though.
Yeah, they had to buy back, but I think it might have been worth it though. But like, if they had Brewmaster ulti there, they would have been complete wiped out. But I think Shazam were just a little bit too overconfident. They dived the tower a little bit too much, but still a decent trade there for Elite Wolves, even though they had to buy back.
Yeah, so it's a good job by Elite Wolves defending there, and certainly puts a big dent in the lead of Shazam. But the Lone Druid, still fine, almost has the Relic, and they know that they have to get a kill on him soon. Let's see if they can find it. Smash, of course, does have that Primal Split. He's going to go throw it out. TC just standing there. He has to take it, and now taking a lot of damage. Can they get the kill on him, though? He's trying to dodge some of it. He uses that Roar as well, but it's looking like he's going to go down. At the same time, there is a lot of push going on to the rest of them. They still haven't killed TC. They swap him back into the rest of them, and Smash turns back into the normal Panda Bear. Van coming back in, trying to get a kill. A Blink Disjoint from Brax. Evil's M got very, very low, but they'll get the Enchantress, and just in time that kill on Lone Druid, putting him 400 away from the Relic.
I really thought he was going to Midas with his burn, unfortunately. Like, I mean, I think he was dead anyway, honestly. I think he should have maybe just used Midas on his burn, and then he might have been able to buy the Relic before he died, but actually Brax might be in trouble as well. Oh my god.
He just goes down immediately. Really well played there from Masoku.
Oh man, it's so annoying though, honestly. When you die and you still got Midas, like, available, it's like the worst feeling, actually. Oh well.
Yeah, just casual things from Elite Wolves. Normally, they win their lanes heavily. This one, they're just saying, hey, it's fine, maybe we didn't win our lanes, we'll work back the lead. They've made it definitely an experience gain in their favor.
One thing I did like what Elite Wolves are doing, though, is that they're kind of just kind of leaving the Brood... Actually, Broodmother, as you expect, is dead.
Yeah, she's gonna go for the TP away. Can she get this assault on?
No way. I was just literally about to say how I like how Elite Wolves are kind of just leaving the Broodmother to be. I think there's two ways to deal with a Broodmother. Either you kind of try and shut him down as hard as possible, or you leave him to do his own thing, because he'll kind of fall off eventually. But unfortunately, Spectre just dies there as a result.
Yeah, I mean, Spectre, it looks like she's decided she's going to save up for the Radiance, getting pretty close, but unfortunately, until she has that, it's not safe to go out.
Like I said, this bot lane, like, there's no one that can really lane bottom with Broodmother being there, because Broodmother will just instantly kill you. They have to try and find plays and kills in the top side of the map before they can really deal with this Broodmother, I think.
Now, Elite Wolves have done a good job of slowing some things down. Brax doesn't have the 4 staff yet, and similarly, I believe the Relic is up on the Lone Druid, but he could have had the whole dang thing already. It's a rough game for Elite Wolves, even if they can get a Radiance up on their Spectre, because you're facing a Lone Druid. What, do you just try to win the teamfight engagements?
Yeah, I think they have to just play to their strength. Oh, there's a smoke here coming from
the side
of Elite Wolves.
There is also a gem up on Smash. He's going to... Okay, now they will know Shazam, most likely, about the gem, and we'll see whether that changes how MSS plays.
Yeah, Shazam need to be really careful, actually, because if they can try and hold off of an engagement before Lone Droid gets his Radiance, they should be in a good position. I think when Lone Droid gets Radiance, I think Shazam could just group up in, as five and try and take a team fight as soon as possible before Spectre picks up his Radiance as well.
Yeah, there's a lot of pressure coming out. Shazam do have a lineup that could effectively split push, and that's something Tinker isn't great about dealing with.
I think for Elite Wolves trying to get back into this game, like, they have to play to their strength. They have to try and find solo pickoffs and kind of gank around the map. Like, they've got Tinker, obviously, who's one of the best heroes to deal with split push, and the heroes to deal with split ganking. So they've got Spectre as well. They try and have to find Shazam by themselves. For example, this Lone Droid is by himself. They need to try and find those kind of heroes, because when Radiance is picked up on Lone Droid, I don't think they can take a teamfight as five. And here comes the Radiance from Lone Droid.
Oh, okay, Smash anyway. Is jumping in with the Primal Roar. He's gonna... Oh, the arrow manages to hit on Brax. This should be a for sure kill. Can they also get SVG here? He's taking a lot of damage on this Enchantress, of course, has that healing. The burst is more than enough. And the coconuts come out from Witch Doctor, but they do nothing. So looking like a tier 1 for the lineup of Elite Wolves. But as you said, Radiance is up on that bear.
It's still a good jump, though. They realised that Lone Droid was not going to TP in, and Brumov was in the bot lane, so the worst comes to worst. It was a 3v5 for the side of Elite Wolves, and that's the kind of ganks they have to be trying to find, because they're incredibly mobile. Like, they got Tinker and Spectre, two incredibly mobile heroes, and they just got to try and find their engagements where they're the strongest.
Yep. Now they're going to continue forwards. Elite Wolves just really trying to push this advantage. Batrider will be back up soon. Yeah, they are TPing all the way out, even the Marana Leap, to ensure them a safe escape. Also, they have to deal with MSS, wave cutting. The dust, I believe it was just off the mark. They do have a gem, of course, up on this Brewmaster. They're actually gonna pop the ult running to make sure they all do get out. It's looking like both teams cleanly disengaging.
And for Shazam, like, their only initiation is Batrider. Like, they have to rely solely on this Batrider to get good jumps. I think their best jump is perhaps... I think if they can catch the Brewmaster before he ulties, like, that will definitely secure Shazam the team fight. But it all depends, obviously, initiation and vision. But, like, without it, like, they don't have it, like, any kind of lockdown except for, like, a Witch Doctor Stun, which isn't enough, really. So they have to solely rely on this Batrider. But they're going to take Roshan now, and I think they can just slow siege the T2s now for the side of Elite Wolves.
On the upside, for Elite Wolves, they've got a Radiance on the way for Spectre. She's picked up the Relic, and obviously there's a couple of good blinks here that'll stop. It'll also just increase her damage output. It'll really bring a world of hurt to fun. This Witch Doctor already having trouble surviving the haunts, and it's not going to get any easier.
I think the bigger thing, though, is that it's going to stop the blink from Batrider. Because I mentioned how the team fights for Shazam want to go. I think they have to catch the Brewmaster before he ulties with a Batrider blink. But obviously, if Spectre Haunt is going to stop that completely. And if you stop the blink rider from Batrider, there's no way that Brewmaster won't get his ultimate off. And when he does get his ultimate off, I think they have a chance to win team fights, particularly, or just solely because of that ultimate. It's such a big factor, honestly.
Mirana already has a Lotus Orb. I love this. I am super impressed. It's not an item we often see as the first item pickup on any hero, but I really like that Masoku has decided that, hey, Lotus Orb, it's really going to save us from a lot of business this game. Let's get one up.
Oh, arrow again.
Did they?
Oh my god.
Okay, Brax, he is just dead. There's no escape here. And another fantastic arrow by Masoku.
I have to admit, this Mirana is playing out of this world, honestly. This whole game, if there wasn't a Mirana, or if Mizuku wasn't playing this Mirana, like, Elite Wolves would be in such a bad position. There's been so many kills that have been set up by this Mirana, and honestly, it's winning them this game, put simply. If Mirana was not in this game, like, Shazam would be destroying, put simply, but they're not at the moment.
I tell this story every time I cast Elite Wolves, but I remember when Complexity qualified for MDL over Elite Wolves. They actually were knocked into the lower bracket by Elite Wolves, and then Swindle and I were casting a game together, and he just says, look, we're just gonna ban Mirana against Elite Wolves because they can't do anything if they don't have her. And this is exactly what it is. Masoku lands arrows that get them back into this game. They were approaching 7.5k net worth behind and not looking like they had any way back into the game in sight, and they have brought it back down to a zero net worth difference, a zero experience difference. And they have the
it's
Spectre.
It's just remarkable, honestly. Like, it's so crazy to think that one hero can actually have that much of a big of an impact, particularly on a hero that's not really picked up that much in the scene, honestly. But this hero, it's one of those heroes that it's like either hit or miss, and at the moment this guy is hitting every single arrow and it's really paying off as a result. But they're still in a bad position though. Like, obviously Shazam are still very, very strong. They've got Radiance, they've got, you know, Broodmother with Orchid as well, so they have to be careful. But so far these ganks have really given Elite Wolves at least a chance in this game.
Now Enchantress here, she hasn't gone for the Dragon Lance actually. This is a full support Mirana, but even then, not Mirana, Enchantress, words please. I'm much more used to seeing her go Dragon Lance before the Ags.
Yeah, definitely. Normally you always see Dragon Lance before the Ags. It's just better build up and better sustain. But with the Midas picked up here as well, it's a little bit peculiar. But
okay, they're getting ready to go in. Brax actually blinks a very small amount, and already the Primal Split coming out. There is the Haunt back off cooldown, and they blow up Fun. Next, they're going in onto MSS. He pops his BKB. M-God actually taking a huge amount of damage here. The Minus Alma, Minus Aura, though, maybe will help them out. But Iwo already low. They're going to lose their Spectre. They have to get out this Primal Splitter because he has the gem. They cannot lose Smash. Fan comes back in, is throwing down some Motion Machines. MSS probably cannot follow further. And they'll be able to hold this, but they did lose their Spectre. A teamfight that went completely the way of Shazam.
Yeah, definitely. This just goes back to really the Radiance and the Bear and the Broodmother really having a big impact. Like the last sort of three or four team fights, Broodmother has not been there because he's been bot lane, but now Shazam are playing as a team and sort of fighting with the Broodmother, and it's having a massive impact. The Brewmaster ulties are still doing a lot of work, but this Broodmother is still such a big problem.
Yeah, they also, the new BKB being shown up by the Broodmother, just very little that the Spectre could do against her.
Exactly, like that BKB.
Now, they're actually going to throw the stun out onto MSS. He takes a little bit of damage here. Smash has to play very conservatively, and they've gripped on Masoku. The swap comes out from the Vengeance. Masoku already at half health. They'll burn down the Aegis at the very least. They also get the Bear immediately resummoned by TC. They use the Moonlit Shadows in an attempt to initiate, but the Sentry already down, and now MSS taking a lot of damage here. He's going to get busted. Dagon being shown off by Van, already level 2. And Shazam, they need to back away.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Mini, I believe you're not pushing your push-to-talk key. Ordered. Or you're dead. Either of these outcomes is unacceptable. Oh, he has been disconnected, apparently. Mini died? Oh, this is not a good day for us. We still have a chase continuing. This arrow, finally one gonna go wide for the Mirana. And I'm gonna check to see if Mini is back at all. You know it's a bad day when you're... assigned co-caster has a power outage, and then your backup also has internet problems. So hopefully Mini will be back with us shortly. But in the meantime, looking over that lost team fight, somewhat in Elite Wolves' favor, but also have to remember that they did just lose the previous team fight. So it's still not... they're not in the best of positions, and the game is still very even, maybe even a little bit of a lead for Shazam, of course, with how big this Lone Druid is, topping the net worth chart, has the Radiance, has, you know, everything you could want, has the Vlads up now. The Motion Machine's gonna cover this push, and Smash also has the Primal Split, so Shazam not looking interested in coming in. Brax, he wants to see if he can find a jump. Obviously, if he can get Smash, that's a big old target, but you have to be careful. Anytime the Venge is up, oh goodness, while Van is just being a jerk on the back lines. Yeah, they had to destroy that ward. M-God looking for a swap. Brax coming in. If he can catch out. Oh, he does. He manages to get the Venge. They don't have a response to that, but immediately they pick off the Witch Doctor and the Batrider too. Tinker doing mad work. Iwo now working in onto SVG. Kind of an odd target to go after with the Untouchable, but Swap stops her from TPing away. They've also caught out the Bear. The Bear does have a Okay, he has a resummon shortly, so he doesn't need to worry too much about that. But suddenly, Elite Wolves, they have blown this game wide open. They get the stun on the Bears. We talked about Lone Druid does have a resummon, but MSS pops his BKB, gets to use it on nothing, and TC, if he goes down, they have no defense all of a sudden. Elite Wolves, they take a tier 2, and they just lead into taking the base. Iwo very low, but gonna get owned up here again. And out of nowhere, Elite Wolves taking teamfight after teamfight. What a turnaround there. Now, again, they have cover of March of the Machines, but it looks like Elite Wolves gonna take the safe option, not even ensuring the tower, just wanting to back on out and wait till the next big team fight. Also gonna go for a Moonlit Shadows there. See what they can do. Obviously a huge big swing for them. Almost 7.5k in their lead. And taking a look around, we can see it's gonna end up pumping out into their items. Ag's already been up on Smash, also has the Vlad's Aether Lens on Mystico. And then Mirana might be able to get herself something pretty. It's a mech to go with her early Lotus Orb that was doing a lot of work there. And for Shazam, suddenly they need to be very careful because taking one bad teamfight like that really can put you back. Their racks are exposed. Now, obviously, Shazam gonna be feeling like they're no longer in the driver's seat. MSS, he doesn't have Necro Books or anything, but you can always fold back on Broodmother, pressuring other lanes. It does feel like Elite Wolves are getting their Spectre, though, into the point where she no longer has to super worry about the spiders as much. So she's got a little bit more freedom there. MSS is not really showing exactly what he wants to do. He also has webs in kind of not the best places for pushing, so you'd have to get all of those set up. While again, with the cover of Monster of the Machines, Elite will push another tier 2. At some point, Shazam have to decide to fight. They can't, you can't just keep avoiding these fights, like, it's not the best of strategies. Aegis is going to be a long respawn timer, almost 11 minutes there, so this is a saving grace for Shazam. They will buy themselves some time to try and get some stuff done. Oh gosh, he's going off to MSS! Tinker, just being a little bit cutesy there. And I do wonder, he's saving up a lot of gold, he's not upgrading the Dagon, it does have diminishing returns per cost. Oh, excellent, Mini is alive again, let me just move him in. Thank goodness, let's just say that. Thank goodness you're back and alive, Mini. Oh,
I apologize. Oh,
it's clearly English internet, yeah.
English internet, man, is actually horrible. I need to move country. If anyone has any suggestions or recommendations, that would be greatly appreciated.
There's gonna be a teamfight with the Lotus Orb! They're stuck in place and Brax, he's gonna probably fall from this. They're trying to pound into Smash, but Dagon comes out, just finishes him off, and now they also manage to kill off Fun. Emesis is trying his best to fight. He probably will kill off Masoku here, but is it enough? He needs to get some damage done on someone else. The bear getting very low. There is a resummon at the ready for TC, but they need to back on up, and Savage, he's gonna get caught out here. Do they bring him down? Untouchable actually doing a mad amount of work along with the healing wisp. Does up to 1,000 heal at max level, but here comes Tinker. Dagons don't care about your Untouchable, and Elite Wolves, they are poised to push Arax.
What even happened in the 5 minutes I was gone for? All I know is that Shazam were winning and now they're like losing Arax.
Sorry about that. You kind of missed the only important super key part of the game. Just Elite Wolves, they took a tier 2 and then won a team fight after it against Shazam and managed to get themselves a Rax. You can take a look around, but it looks like Elite Wolves, they're thinking about continuing to push. The Tinker, of course, has TP'd away. Smash has to be careful. He doesn't want to give up the gem here. And Tinker does choose to upgrade his Dagon. I wasn't sure he was going to do it. Thought maybe he'd go for a sheep to deal with stuff like the bear. But
Really, he's got rank 2 boots of travel as well, actually. That's really interesting.
Oh no, I think that's... it is. Okay, I thought he was the cosmetic
and
mixing you
I
up.
Think, that. I think the reason being is because it hinges...
Mini, if you died again, I'm actually gonna make fun of you. I'm really hoping he just forgot to use his push to talk key, but I'm pretty sure what Mini was trying to say is that, I still see him in TeamSpeak. What I think he was trying to say is that it synergizes really well with the panda split and so on. And it certainly helps you set up, so. Now, the Roshan has respawned. And, we've got a pause. Hopefully that'll give me some time to get back. We're just gonna carry on, folks. We've got ourselves a Roshan. This might be, I say it might be all that Elite Wolves need to end this game out, but I don't know that they need much to end this game out. They are 10,000 net worth ahead, 7.5k experience. There's not a good answer on Shazam all of a sudden, and Tinker can actually bring down this Lone Druid Bear twice at this point. Aegis goes down, they put it on the Spectre. That is a terrifying target, and she is looking ripped. She's got a lot of damage coming out from her, from them. Oh, okay, they swap onto Brax, they're gonna get a stun out of him. Can they kill him off? But no, the pull comes out onto M-God. Brax getting very low. Spectre gonna finish him off now. TC standing there trying to fight up the Spectre, but even with a BKB on the bear, Spectre still kind of winning that engagement. Fun gonna be shown off to the sidelines there. The Primal Split doing good work. There is a gem on the deck, but TC getting very low here, and the TP in onto Iwo. He is just gonna help Tinker finish off one, and now the Coconuts are bouncing, but Savage not in a good spot. Tinker just comes in with the dagons. This might just be GG coming out. And they might have Fun caught out on the sidelines, but with no bear, or with Broodmother getting caught out as well, MSS goes down. That's a GG. And that's gonna be it. Elite Wolves still very much in the running to contest DC for the land spot in the WePlay League Season 3. Folks, I hope you enjoyed it. Sorry about the technical issues coming out here. You know, clearly, Universe telling me that they do not want me to have a co-caster, which I think is a big mistake. Either way, I hope you guys had fun. When he could be here, that was Mini Esports joining me. You can find him by Twitter on that handle. I am Llama Down Under. You can find me on Twitter as well. I'd love any and all feedback to make the casting better. If you tell me to fix Britain's internet, that's a little bit outside the scope of my abilities. And I believe this is the last America's game for a while, since, of course, DC can't play out their game, since 1437 is coaching secret, I think, in China right now for the Shanghai Majors. So I hope you all had fun. I hope you're excited for the Majors to start potentially on time soon, and I'll see you next time. Peace out, everyone.